Hello from ChemHelp ASAP. IC50 values are a great way to report the potency of an enzyme inhibitor, but KI values have an advantage. Here is a sigmoidal curve from which an IC50 value for a competitive reversible inhibitor can be read. It's an inhibition curve. And you see them regularly in drug discovery. Each of the data points is a separate experiment. The concentrations of enzyme and substrate are constant, and only the concentration of the inhibitor is changed. It's very important to keep the concentration of the substrate constant. Remember that this is a curve for a competitive reversible inhibitor. The substrate and inhibitor are both competing for the same active site. If you change the conditions of the competition, add or remove substrate, then the IC50 will change. More substrate gives a similar curve, but the observed IC50 value will be different. More substrate gives a higher IC50, and that appears as a lower potency. Less substrate gives a lower IC50, a higher potency. This is a problem because drug discovery programs rely on data that can be compared for evaluating inhibitors against one another. You can't actually compare IC50 values unless they are performed using these same conditions with the same substrate concentration. Is there a solution to this problem? Yes. On the screen is something called the Cheng-Prusoff equation. The Cheng-Prusoff equation allows one to convert an IC50 value to a KI. KI is the inhibition equilibrium constant. It is the dissociation equilibrium constant for an enzyme inhibitor complex. KI is a property of an enzyme and an inhibitor. It does not depend on other factors like substrate concentration. KI is considered to be a more pure potency measure for a competitive reversible inhibitor. Using the Cheng-Prusoff equation does require some information. You need the Km of the substrate for the enzyme. You also need to know the concentration of the substrate used in the binding assay. Note that when you do this conversion, KI will always be a little smaller than IC50, since the denominator will always be at least greater than or equal to 1. So IC50 values tend to misreport potency. The potency is typically a little bit better and in the KI form as reported. Now, if you look up drug potencies, you will certainly encounter both IC50 and KI values. KI values are more convenient because they can be directly compared to one another. I hope this video was helpful for you. Please subscribe, like, or leave a comment or question. Take care.